first, she was a role model for a lot of people. I remember going to the White House the day that we dedicated the LBJ Memorial Grove. And I have wonderful pictures of President Ford holding the hand of my then two little daughters as they were hopping down stones and in this rough spot. And he's holding on, and I think the youngest one was young enough that her fancy drawers were showing coming down the steps. Betty then had us over, Mrs. Ford had us over to the White House and let us go upstairs and look at the rooms that we had shared. Because I think most of the people, or many of them who live there, feel in some way that it's theirs. What have they done to my room? I can't speak for any of the Fords, but I came there when I was a young college girl and left there with a 3-month-old baby. I was in and out in that time, of course, but I did spend some quality time there. And I know what it's like to open the upstairs to the outside world. It's the only sanctuary you have. You know when you go outside that they're all going to be asking you questions and making judgments. And for Mrs. Ford to have us upstairs and let us see the old rooms is a real treat. And she just gave us the best tour over, you know, the best tour ever. And we then went home, Mother Lucy, and went back to our house in McLean. And there we heard that she was going on to the hospital have an operation. And even now it just makes me tear up to think that she would spend her last times, minutes of that day with us instead of nestled with her children or feeling sorry for herself. And she was not a pity person. She faced life with this great adventure and went forth and taught us a lot about cancer with the big C, which nobody ever mentioned, the unspeakable, there we go. And then later taught us about how to handle other health problems. And so I just greatly admire her, and I've known